Hey yo, what's up YouTube? What's up my people? Man, it's been a while since I've been away, you know? Like, it's been a while, and I won't blame it on anything, but I would definitely blame it on the summer. Look, the summer was hectic for me, guys. Like, it was really hectic. It was fun. Like, I really enjoyed myself, you know, and that's why I haven't had the time to react. But I have been thinking about reactions, doing reactions a lot, because yeah, I just miss interacting with you, listening to new music, and just getting feedback, which the feedback that you guys have been giving me have been great so far, and I really appreciate it. So much positive feedback trying to encourage me to continue with the reactions, and people appreciating my perspective and point of view on certain topics and things that I listen and hear through music. So yeah, man, thank you and big ups to all of those. And of course, the channel has been growing very slow, but growing nonetheless. So I'm also like really have been motivated by that growth as well, and that what actually encouraged me to come back and do the reactions. But also just missing listening to fresh music, new music, and also interacting and reacting and being in front of the camera. And what else? Yeah, just being in that space has been something that I've been longing for deep down in my heart, but I didn't have the time to do it. But now South Africa is in winter and I'm back, and I'm gonna be here forever, like doing this full blown without any week being skipped. You know, that's the best I can promise, without any week going by without me dropping an action a reaction for you guys. So what I thought was like, okay, let me just go through the Murder by Side B album by Eminem, and I never got to finish that album, unfortunately. I never got to finish reacting to it. I never got to even listen to the rest of the songs. I literally stopped, you know, because I was listening to the songs as I'm reacting to them, and I stopped, and then my life just took, you know, it just digressed and took a different way, and I never got back to the camera and got back to the album and listened to it. So I'm excited to continue and complete the album with you guys. I'm just gonna do a marathon. I think that I'm gonna do this reaction at one go. I'm doing the whole album this evening. Now, there are lots of songs, and I've been getting a lot of reaction suggestions for you guys from you guys on which artists I should look out for. So I need to get to those new to that music, you know, or to those artists. So yeah, man, enough talking. I don't want to talk a lot, but I'm just glad to be here. I'm happy to hear. I hope you guys are well and you're doing good. Look, let's get into this reaction today. I stopped, you know, so my last reaction was on Book on Rhyme, Book of Rhymes. And now I'm gonna be checking out, or today or this evening, I'm gonna be checking out the reaction Favorite Bitch. That's the name of the song. I don't know what to expect. I just know that it's gonna be crazy just by the name of the title of the song, Favorite B. God, I don't know what I'm into, I'm in for, but just take this journey with me. Let's go.
First love, right? But what it turned into is like, you know, these cats got it now. She just like a hoe. For real, you know what I'm saying? Like music, my first love, right? But what it turned into is like, you know, these cats got it now. She just like a hoe.
She ain't doing
you know
nothing.
what I mean? Yeah. Switched it up, and everybody used to shit on it now.
Who's speaking there? I don't know who's speaking. It doesn't say there's anyone featured on this track, but there's someone speaking, but I don't recognize the voice. So let me know who's speaking on that intro there. But let's go.
Mumble rap, ain't no more substance and shit, right? Don't treat it the way it needs to be treated. I kinda want that old thing back.
Yeah, I was young, I was hungry, I was chasing the bag. At 21, I was lucky to find an uneven fucking honey bun. I forgot about now, I got money falling out. 50s, 100s, and 20s, and I know nothing is funny about the man just bombing. But we got something in common, both of us are alarming. Foul, disgusting, and awful, so repugnant and ugly. I could give the boss a marathon, a run for its money, yeah. And you could say I'm a little bit immature, but this type of...
Wait, was that a jab on Buster? Wait, did I hear that right? I'll give a bust, like, I mean, a marathon, something like that.
Give the bust a marathon, a run for its money, yeah. And you could say I'm a little bit immature, but this type of literature got me a little richer. But I get insecure when the mother dudes hit on you, girl. You're letting them fiddle with your clitoris. Remember you were
my favorite bitch. Things will never be the same. Ain't it funny how you change up and flip the script? You don't let a bunch of lanes fall through and go pray that I can't pray. You ain't have to do it like that. Told you I'd be right back. What you did, I needed to cheat. Like the music, I had to bounce on my favorite.
Always needed my smile. Mama told me it's goofy. I'd get picked on in school. Come home and she'd school me. She never sugarcoated it.
This is an interesting flow that Eminem has here. I won't lie. It's an interesting flow. And I love the story. You know, like basically, this is a metaphor. So favorite beat, the beat is hip hop. It's rap game. It's the art that he's doing. That's his favorite beat. So yeah, I love the metaphor. I love the metaphor, and the flow is quite interesting. You know, and yeah, it's a chill song. It's a chill song. Not too much, you know, into it. It's just him expressing his love and his relationship with hip hop.
That if I wasn't so stupid and ugly, I wouldn't always get bullied. I think of my struggles and get emotional. Could be cause how behind the eight ball and far in the hole that they put me. Now I'm a roll like a tootsie. I'm just trolling you pussies, but I'm like a stroller cause you'll see just how I roll if you push me.
But that's what I do this music for. When I was going through some of the hardest times I drew from her. But she's like the devil cause I just can't let loose of her. Cause the thought of losing her makes me wanna just let loose of her.
She's just like a devil. I can't get loose. I can't get loose of her. I think that's what he said on the chorus or that bridge there. Man, the devil is a liar, but the devil surely is a hard competitor to beat. But he is a liar though.
Find a rendezvous with her. Tell her it's a butt dial, girl. Yeah, booty call. That's how it used to be. Cause you and me, we were the world.
Was like a punch or something, but what?
Girl, yeah, booty call. That's how it used to be. Cause you the devil, cause I just can't let loose of her. Cause the thought of losing her makes me wanna just let loose of her. Then I hit the studio, find a rendezvous with her. Tell her it's a butt dial, girl, yeah, booty call. That's how it used to be. Cause you and me, we were.
So, tell her it's a butt dial, girl, it's a booty call. That's a nice play on words there.
And we made Curtis blow. Fuck, I missed them days. He used to be.
Yeah. They made Curtis blow indeed.
And we made Curtis blow. Fuck, I missed them days. He used to be my favorite.
Yo, I miss those days when Eminem and Curtis / AKA 50 Cent. Yo, that era, that decade of music was fire. Like, all the incredible artists that we consider today as legends, you know, the 2000s, like from 2001, actually from 2000, maybe from 1990 something, since DMX came out, but DMX really blew in 2000. From 2000 up until 2010, like that decade, we got real MCs and rappers who were spitting bars and making great music. Like great music. Like music that you can actually listen to and learn from it. Not this thing that we are hearing today. My God.
Things will never be the same. Ain't it funny how you change up and flip the script? You don't let a bunch of lanes fall through and go play that I can't pray. You ain't have to do it like that. Told you I'll be right back. What you did, I needed a chick. Like the music, I had to bounce on my favorite bitch.
You fucking leaving me, bitch?
I don't get that line. Like the music, I had to bounce on my favorite. Oh, so it's like, I don't know what does the bounce mean there? Please explain. I don't want to get it wrong, but like the music, I would love to bounce, which I would like to leave, like my favorite beat. What does that actually mean? That he would love to leave hip hop, but he can't, you know? Anyway, you guys explain.
I don't think so. Sit your motherfucking ass down. I swear to God, you run to that door, I'm gonna put one in the back of your fucking head. I'm gonna ask you this one time. Answer better be yes. Would you marry me again? Now that everything has changed, yeah. It'll never be the same as the era whence we came. From Nas to Pac, Rock, yeah. Eric B and Kane. But I know a few from this era that are lyrically insane. And all the most are never gonna hit the level called Louisa yet. Or be emotionally attached to your MTV raps. Yeah. Running home from school.
The level of Wheezy had, none of them will reach the level of craziness that Wheezy had. So that's a shout out to Lil Wayne.
Never gonna hit the level called Louisa yet. Or be emotionally attached to your MTV raps. Yeah. Running home from school to catch an episode. The feeling that it gave you to rip the plastic off the tape you hold and peel it back. Yeah, tear it off and play it. Swear to God, 4 o'clock. We cried around the TV, bought it in his underwear and socks. When Nani was con artist and Poof had his hair and locks. Yeah, back when Flavor Flav had us wearing clocks. Went back with Ed Lover. Yeah. And there was two Dr. Dre's. That's a pair.
That the era of Flavor, I wasn't even in tune into it. Like, I'm totally clueless when it comes to that era.
But I never thought I'd get so jealous at the thought of letting you go psychologically. It's gonna bother me. My eyes are already watery. Part of me, I wanna stop till I get you back. If I gotta put the work in and tell you I'm never giving this up. Other part wants to tell you just to get fucked. Go back to whatever dick that you suck. Get back together with the new slut. Giving up the vagina like a trip to the gyna. Kinda just wanna help you become bigger than you were. But I guess it has slipped your mind. You must be biding your time. Looking for someone to come along that'll make you feel like I did back when you were mine, huh?
Yeah.
But truthfully, it was never really you and me exclusively. It is too many new MCs you can choose between. But no matter how many motherfuckers rant, but they can't do it like me. But I can't keep burning the candle at both ends that I can't handle it. When I leave and you find another one, now I gotta take this beat and dismantle it. I won't breathe and I kill you, but if I can't have you, bitch, nobody can kill me. I used to be your favorite bitch.
Yeah, I mean, when it comes to lyrics, Eminem will never disappoint, but I won't lie, this is not my type of song. I didn't like it. I love the lyrics, the content, you know, and what he was saying on the music, but this is not my cup of tea. I was not feeling it. I'm sorry, but with this one, nope, I didn't feel the song. But the content, of course, Eminem will never disappoint none of us when it comes to that. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this reaction, and yeah, I will see you guys on my next reaction. My name is Kolisa. Peace.